To my surprise, when I presented the news to Marion that Sir Guy wanted to see her, my lady wouldn't hear of it.
My lord!
I was puzzled. Of course, she was still in shock from her experiences, but surely, a man who had known her and her family well and who was clearly feeling the loss of his friends deserved to be seen. I could sense that Marion was holding something back. With a sigh, she crossed to the table and poured herself some wine, drinking it down as if composing herself. Then she turned, and it came out.
The guy's visits were always an occasion for my father. But I was wary of the man, more so as I grew up and his interest in me changed.
What happened, Marion?
I started to become a woman.
Did you talk to your father?
How could I? Go to him and say that his oldest friend made me nervous? No, my lord, I did not talk to him.
I'm sorry. And I'm sorry I have to say this, but you have to see him. He's one of the king's favourites. To snub him is to snub the crown.
I know. And I know very well it has to be a private audience. Anything less, an insult. But having told someone of my fears makes me feel better.
How could I be happy at this? Nonetheless, the arrangements were made. On the appointed night, I was restless. A frantic banging on my chamber door had me in a sweat. As I crossed to it, I could only hope to see one of the guards, or perhaps one of my servants with some trivial problem that needed my attention. Sadly, my fears were confirmed when I opened the door and Marion threw herself into my arms. She was dishevelled, bruised, and her gown was torn. Most worrying of all, she had blood, a lot of blood, on her hands and spattered over her dress. She was also sobbing uncontrollably. I quickly brought her into my room, making sure no one was around.
He came, the guy. He pushed his way in. I was pacing up and down, shouting. So agitated, Philip, and his eyes...
Marion.
His eyes had madness in him.
Marion, I need you to slow down and tell me what happened.
He kept telling me about his feelings for me. It was clear he had been drinking. I asked him to leave. I told him we could meet again in the morning.
Where is he?
He attacked me, Philip. I was in fear for my life.
Marion, where is he?
In the struggle. I found his knife at his waist. I used it, Philip. I used it on him. He's in my chambers. He's dead.
Dead? No, no, I'm sure... You only thought you killed him. It'll be a cut, and that's all, a nasty cut. Sit down, wait here. I'll go and see to him. I crept through the castle towards Marion's chambers. When I reached the door and listened, there was only silence. And there was no choice but to go in. The place was a mess. There had clearly been a struggle. The overturned furniture, scattered parchments, and there, on the floor, face down, Sir Guy. I crossed quickly to him and looked for signs that he might still be alive, but his body was cold. It was then that I noticed something had fallen from Sir Guy's hand, a small, delicate gold locket on a fine chain. I opened it. What I saw was the likeness of a striking lady, young with long blonde hair. The artist had captured the vivid blue of her eyes, and it seemed that there was a warmth about her. There was an inscription. I read it. For my brave Sir Guy, may God keep you safe. My love always, Marion de Guise. Marion de Guise. Then I noticed that Sir Guy had scrawled something on the stone floor, one word that was difficult to make out at first, but when I held a candle close over it, I saw that it was written in the only thing that he had available to him, his own blood. The word chilled me as I read it. Imposter. My mind was racing and a wave of nausea overcame me. I took deep breaths and tried to steady myself. What did this mean? Could it be true that Marion was not all that she seemed? No, I thought. But then Sir Guy had written imposter. I needed my wits about me and I needed to find out for certain just exactly who was waiting for me in my chambers. Because it seemed it wasn't the Lady Marion. Thank you.
Did I kill him? I've been sitting here hoping this is a dream, just a bad dream.
I'm afraid it's real. The answer is yes, you killed him. My lady, while you've been hoping this is a dream, do you know what I've been hoping?
No.
I've been hoping you can tell me who you are.
I don't understand, Philippe.
Really? Have a look at this. It's a locket. So, guys, have a look on the inside. Nothing, Lady Marian? Oh, but that's right. Not Lady Marian, no. But you are someone who's taken me for a fool. He wrote something in your room. The word imposter. I think you have some explaining to do.
You believe the fantasy of this locket, Philippe. There are plenty of poor artists who will paint whatever dream their patron desires.
That's true, but the courage it must have taken for him to write that word tells me everything I need to know.
Anyone can write a word, Philippe. That is no example of courage.
It is when they have to use their own blood to do it. That's a knight's courage, woman. Nothing to say? My patience is wearing thin.
Philippe, I...
Don't. Just don't. I want the truth.
The truth? Then I must confess. I am not Marion. I am her servant.
What?
My lord, all I told when Prince John made me speak our court is true, save for the choice that was forced upon me. Our carriage did crash as the French chased us. Marion died. Not straight away, but the journey back to the manor was not kind. She was badly wounded. I told them that I was the Lady Marion. I had spent so much time with her that they never knew, never suspected I was anything other than nobility. The rest you know. I did finish them as I described. It was that or face the same fate as my lady.
And Sir Guy.
I had hoped to explain to him, but when he saw me... You see, he had asked for Marion's hand. In his grief and rage, he attacked me. For the second time, I had no choice, fight or die.
You stole a noble lady's life.
Do you judge me? What use are the dead? I made a choice to live, to preserve her and to become hope. Am I so different to you now? Are you so shallow, Philippe? Ask yourself what you would have done in my place. Consider what Prince John was able to do with my testimony.
And there it was. She was right. Because of her, Prince John had been able to rally the nobles, but I was sheriff. And I was torn. Torn between my feelings for this woman and my conscience. A man lay dead and a servant was masquerading as a noble lady. I thought about it. The royal court was full of secrets. Would one more matter? As for having legitimate claim to titles, well, let's just say half the nobles shouldn't be there. I also knew that to make the true details known about the woman stood before me would mean incurring the anger of Prince John, an experience that would have an uncertain outcome. No one else knew the truth. We were bound together now. I looked at her and made my decision. To save Marion, I needed the help of my closest friend.